Okay, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for coming this evening. I'm George Valentin, I'm the principal of the school. We are really excited for our first annual Night at the Heights. So thank you so much for being here and supporting our arts programs in our building. Welcome to the Montgomery Museum of Modern Art. We're gonna take you away into our story right away, so I'm gonna turn it over to our talented students. Thank you very much, everyone.
Sir, just before we do, I had one thing I wanted to say. selling it to one of these people, selling it to Sir Robinson Snob's Art Gallery. It deserves to be displayed in the museum for all to see.
Jack, you're still so young. The true value of this art is the money we can sell it for. Now let's go. Tour. It is nice to meet you, Mr.
Clearwater. Karen's Clearwater, Clearwater Oil, and I am looking for something expensive to decorate my 16th bathroom.
All right. And Miss Velvet?
Valerie Velvet of Velvet Cosmetics. I'm looking for a piece of art that's going to match the beautiful aesthetic of my new lipstick line, Scarlet. That particular line of cosmetics is not selling as well as I'd like, and I'm hoping some art's going to spark my imagination.
And of course I recognize.
Of course you do. You must have seen my talk show. Yes, that's me, Eileen Roseberry of Everyone Loves Eileen.
I think I saw you in the news a few days ago, something about an
That was nothing. Just a disgruntled former employee. Some people say the meanest things on social media. Anyways, art looks really good myself.
And Miss Angelica, how's the husband, Carl?
Dead. Although, he's very old.
I'm so sorry. How old is he?
47. It's all right, though. I'm looking for love again, and I'm hoping the fourth marriage sticks.
And who might you be? I don't think I recognize you.
My name is Pacifica Holloway, and the reason you don't know my name is because I'm not like all these other insane one percenters that live off an insane amount of dirty money. I'm here on behalf of an environmental organization that is going to sue every single person in this room for the damages that they have caused.
Emma, why do we invite you?
Her parents are actually worth over $8 billion.
Oh, never mind then. Let's get on to the art.
Start with
it. That one's selling for $4 million.
Sold.
Wait, what?
Already?
Get a chance to win.
$5 million.
Sold. Emma, write that down.
Okay.
All right. Well, I'd like to start describing this piece now. It's probably one of my favorites in the gallery. I love how you can see the stream going through the center of the painting. It almost seems to represent the very water of life, the crane bursting from it, the birth of a new life, the graffiti representing the turmoil of someone's youth, the CDs, the broken dreams of a tortured artist. There's so much movement and life in this piece. It's truly, truly wonderful.
My second husband loved hunting cranes. Always out shooting clay pigeons.
You mean skeets?
Whatever you want to call them. But maybe that was my first husband.
All right, well, on to the second piece now. This is a particularly wonderful artwork. It's made by an up-and-coming impressionist artist from New York. I really love it because it reminds me of a storm, and not a storm of the weather, mind you, but a storm of the soul.
You know, it reminds me of a rainbow in an oil spill.
Yeah, I'm sure you would know all about that.
All right, well, on to our final piece before the main event. This is a wonderful artwork made 100 years ago by a rather obscure French artist, but I think that it's probably one of my all-time favorites, not just in the gallery, the way that it...
Oh, how beautiful! Reminds me of my villa in Spain. In my childhood home. Oh, haunting back the memories of playing with little dollies in my bedroom. Reminds me of a huge spider in a pair of shoes. You know what?
The red of that building reminds me of the color of a lipstick I've been in the process of making. It's coming out my fall 2024 collection, everybody. Don't forget, only $349.99.
Sir, maybe I should go and get the music started. We are running a bit behind.
Great idea, Emma. Go get Mr. Montgomery. Miss Montgomery.
Okay, right away.
All right, and now, finally, what we've all been waiting for. RPS du Resistance.
Jack, stop. I want to unveil this. This is my art. I'm the boss here. Go get me a coffee.
No, but that...
Now!
Yes, sir.
All right, now this, the pièce de résistance, the best art in this gallery. All right, 30, 29, 28, building suspense.
From 30?
To build suspense.
Doesn't that take too long?
Yeah, why not start with something smaller, like 10 or 3?
I told you, to build suspense.
Just get on with it already. I'm looking to buy my new painting.
Your new painting? I think you mean my new painting, buddy?
Wait, wait, no, it's mine. I needed to buy my inspiration for my new lipstick line.
Scarlet.
So you've heard of it then?
Can we just look at this painting? None of us are getting any younger.
Yes, show us.
All right, what number did we decide on?
Just go!
Okay, 3, 2, 1!
Shortly.
job right now.
Na na yo, na na yo, na na yo.
You're letting me take the charge on this one?
I don't tell you this enough, Emma, but you can do this. Now go get it.
Right away.
What about me?
No, I forgot about you. You can go find a toilet to clean or something.
Sir, I don't mean to be rude, but I have a master's degree in art history and I'm a very accomplished painter myself. This work is completely beneath me.
Fine, then go serve some food.
This is ridiculous. No one ever listens to me.
Thank you.
Angelica.
Look, I just wanted to feel closer to my late husband. Scratch that. My late, late, late husband, Henry. Boy, did he love the arts. And me. He used to make me like one of his rich girls.
Miss Eileen?
You know, I'm genuinely surprised you even want to have this conversation with me. I'm Eileen Roseberry. Think someone like me with a spotless record, well, besides the time I went to prison for a month, so someone with an almost spotless record would do anything to those beautiful paintings. I'm just as confused as you are. The lights went up, and all I could hear were screams. A couple of people bumped into me, but I would never do anything to ruin my reputation, and I'm appalled that you seem to think otherwise.
And lastly, Mr. Sanders!
Me? Oh, why would you believe that why would you think I've done this? This is my museum. I take pride in it, and I see no profit in destroying my art. I disagree with the entire premise, Emma. Stop this line of thought right now, or I swear to the Lord, you will never step foot in a museum ever again.
This is ridiculous. All of you here are clearly here for the wrong reasons. I need a minute. As much as I agree with you, I don't really think it's our place to decide
Some of us actually care, Emma, and I think that if you thought about it, you would care too.
You're right. This is all just so insane.
Good luck, Emma. I really hope that you find out whoever stole that painting.
Thanks.
Wait.
Jack, wait!
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Henry.
selfish it is to spend your money on useless art instead of giving it to the greater good, your planet. Velvet! Right. While everyone else screamed like drunk hyenas, the chaos of it all gave me an idea. What if all the love and admiration these silly paintings get went to me instead? And I had to find a way to get the attention on me, and the only thing that I had on me was this cherry bomb lipstick from my very own company. And if I were to take these measures, everyone would see my brand, my lipstick, me. It didn't go as planned, but I'm satisfied.
And lastly,
Terrence!
Listen here. I tried to get that ding dang painting, but if you use your eyes, you would see I missed.
I came here trying to get that protester lady and her protesting buddies always against my oil.
Don't you think the lithium mines where the batteries in your car do more? Y'all should be ashamed. Ashamed.
Tisk.
You see, all this time, we thought that the painting was vandalized, right? I mean, clearly it was. But then when I sat down with Jack, he said something that piqued my interest. He mentioned how the painting was stolen!
As we know that, except for the man who stole it! Jacques, where is it?
I don't know.
Check under there!
Go, go, man.
Thank you, madame.
Not you.
Huh?
Emma!
gathered guests, I thank you all for being a part of our specially